night. All of these things taken together are a racist endeavor on the behalf of the establishment of society. And comrades, this legislation is the worst of all. As you've heard, it isn't just that it seeks to criminalise those who damage racist statues. It isn't just that it takes away our rights of protest. It is that it seeks to criminalise the nomadic style of life. It is a disgrace, and all of us must stand up to it right here and now. Because comrades, those words that are written down for us, those words of freedom, of justice, of equalities, of civil liberties, of rights, of trade union rights, of socialism, of love. Those are not just words written on a page. People lost their lives because those are rights. Those are rights that exist within our
region,
exist within society, exist within each and every one of us. Those are rights that we have a responsibility to pass to the next generation. Those are rights that whenever we see them challenged, that we have a responsibility to stand up as people stood up before us, as generations before us lost their lives. So what we must now stand up here in a square and beyond. Because today's comrades, look around and feel the power of the people who stand next to you. Feel their power and give them your power. Feel the collective. Feel that you can stand up to the establishment and ask for so much more. Comrades, as a socialist and a trade unionist, I stand in front of you asking you to support the GRT community. But I also stand in front of you and ask you to support every woman who was assaulted by the police at the Sarah Everard vigil. I ask you to support every protester assaulted by the police in Bristol for toppling the statue of Colston. I ask you to support every protester who's been in the Black Lives Matter movement. I ask you to support and shout for the family of Sasha Johnson. I ask you to support and shout for the family of Dalian Atkinson. I ask you to support and shout for every refugee criminalised by these fascists and deported in the depths of night. I ask you to speak and shout for every protester who understands it's their responsibility to protect civil liberties. And I ask you, comrades, I ask you to speak and shout for every member of the Gypsy Traveller and Romani community now being criminalised by a society who never have experienced what it is like to lose your home.
You'll lose mine in a few years.
Right here now, it's our responsibility to stand up to establishment politics, both the Conservatives and the Labour Party. The Conservatives for their racist endeavour, and the Labour Party for their failure to provide opposition.
It is time now
for us to feel the strength of a movement, for every trade union leader to say that they will not stand for this. You should be an organised Labour who will cause it. Our movement to come together to reject this. It is time for us to remember the words of Tony Benn whenever he said, "Sorry, Ben, yes, our very existence is to affect change." That is our responsibility now, to affect change, and comrades, to demand social justice for our class. Solidarity.
Thank you very much, Howard. Okay, next I'm going to introduce you to the amazing Ruth from Traveller Pride.
Hello, a truly democratic government exists. Thank you. I'll try it again. A truly democratic government exists to provide representation of its people. The policing bill stands as possibly the most undemocratic piece
the
of legislation
the police should not do any lawmaking.
Racism and lies has yet
absolutely
produced.
Disgusting.
My name is Ruth, and I'm proud to stand in front of you as both a person of Romani heritage, an LGBT plus woman, and as a member of the board of directors of Traveller Pride. Traveller Pride exists as an organisation to provide support, solidarity and representation for travellers who are also a member of the LGBT community. Thank you. Projects have included a support phone line, a solidarity fund and representation for LGBT traveller people for the first time ever at London Pride. One of the best things about Traveller Pride is that it recognises that there is so much variety in our life experiences, our identities and the expression of our lives within the Traveller community. Most importantly, it recognises that we are here and that we are people who have as much right to representation as any other person in the UK.
Yeah.
The current Tory government has formed with trying to frame existence and the rights of various minoritised groups as a debate and a thing they can legislate out of existence. We have seen this with this government in their discussion of immigrants, of our trans siblings, and the narrative they have written about the Traveller community. In the policing bill, the government have used this narrative as a smokescreen to distract from the huge implications of the policing bill for all people. When the police themselves are speaking out against Traveller legislation in a policing bill, you know that something is very wrong. I don't need to tell this audience how that narrative goes. It's the story that as Travellers we are all the same, criminals and antisocial, people who contribute nothing. The very thing that Traveller Pride as an organisation
celebrates,
our individual experiences, our culture and our history, contribute
nothing,
are reduced to a convenient stereotype. This isn't a new story for us. It pervades our government.
Cleaning the byways, clearing old forgotten places, finding stolen byways, literally, where houses build on it.
Challenge that narrative in politics, or committing to improve the provision of sites to allow a greater number of people to stop safely and without harassment.
I won't be put on a site. I'm not a static. I'm a traveller.
And council members to do that work. But opposition parties need to commit to rewriting this narrative if they are serious about undermining this bill. Anecdotally, I live and work in Sussex, and in just 1 week in Jixu Roma Traveller History Month, a month for us to celebrate our rich history and reflect on achievements, the local paper ran 6 anti-traveller articles and gave the Tory MP, Tim Lawton, unlimited platform to make wild claims about travellers with not one bit of fact-checking.
And look him up, I think.
Timler has blocked me on Twitter for finding my questions about whether he'd actually ever spoken to a traveller a little too challenging and scary. Sorry about it, Tim.
Tim Lawson, is it?
People are so busy talking about travellers that they rarely talk to travellers. Even though every single MP has their duty to talk to and work with traveller constituents. I want to bring this back to the LGBT community. As with being a traveller, being LGBT does not mean we have the same life experiences, but we have a shared history of oppression, of attempts to wipe out people and demonise difference. One of the greatest shames of this country was criminalising Alan Turing, a man who in World War II broke the Enigma Code, which saved millions of lives and shortened the war. Alan Turing was convicted for gross indecency due to being a gay man, which ultimately led to him taking his own life. The inability to see beyond a stereotype and to recognise how much he contributed rings frighteningly true. The important role of travellers in the World War II effort is overlooked because it doesn't fit the narrative the government create. Okay. My own great-grandfather, a proud Romani man, fought in World War II and was a Japanese prisoner of war.
Fought in World War II.
Okay. Remember that Pride was a protest. Sorry about that. I really didn't want to cut you, but I knew really need to get the next fantastic speaker up. So now we're going to hear from Delia Matthews from Kill the Bill.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, everybody. It is amazing, absolutely amazing to stand here in the middle of the afternoon and see so many different groupings of people that have come together to support the Gypsy, Roma and Traveller community.
Yeah.
And I can say that the group I'm involved in is United for Black Lives. And we are a coalition of Black Lives Matter groups from across the UK. So I can say with qualification that the Black Lives Matter movement stands in full solidarity with the GRT community.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you another thing. Truth is that the government's bill, this police bill, this racist bill, is a response to the Black Lives Matter uprising last year. That's the truth. And it's also a response
It's Extinction Rebellion as well.
Action that took place last year. That's the truth.
And
we know Throughout history, the British government has always hated the Gypsy, Roma and Traveller community. They want to destroy your way of life. Listen to me, people. Are we going to let this government destroy our voices? Are we going to allow them to take away our human rights?
Never.
Are they going to stop us from calling out injustices that we are subjected to? We cannot. You know, 2 days ago, they took a vote in Parliament. They're not the only ones that can take a vote. They voted to put through the bill. Well, we can take a vote out here. This is a vote of the people.
Yeah.
I'm in favour of a vote of no confidence against this racist government.
Stupid.
Yes. Is there any against? No? Is there any abstentions? No, that was unanimous vote, people. That is the strength of feeling in all communities across this nation against this pernicious police crime sentencing and court spell. You know, for hundreds of years, underrepresented communities have used both protests as a way to have our voices heard. For hundreds of years. For hundreds of years, organized workers have used protests as a way to make their demands. For hundreds of years, the Gypsy, Roma and Traveller community have had your traditions. This racist government has no right to try and take those rights away from you.
And
we will not let them.
COVID.
We will never, ever, ever stop. We will continue to protest and continue to...
Human rights.
One part in the bill is that they're going to measure the volume of our protest. Have you ever heard shit like this in your life? They are going to measure the volume of
Civil
our...
War.
They're going to measure the decibels. This government is a disgrace.
Yep.
We hate them as
Disgusting
much as they hate us.
Pigs.
And we will never, ever, ever, ever stop protesting.
Stealing everyone's money, rules,
stocks, everything. We are the people. There's nothing stronger than
stealing with taxes, stealing our water, selling it on, privatising the police.
Black Lives Matter
Disgusting.
And Kill the Beneficial have stood in solidarity with you. We will not stop. We're going to lobby the Lords or wherever we have to lobby. We have to campaign on every single front. There's no one way to tackle this bill. This movement is about fighting this bill on all angles. So it's everything. All hands on deck. Every angle that we can, we fight. But here what we're going to do. In August, we're going to have a Kill the Bill National Day of Action.
Yes.
And I'm saying to your community, the GRT community, that just as we stood in solidarity with you today, come and stand in solidarity with us on the 21st of August and join us with the People's Assembly and Extinction Rebellion.
People's
Let's make some fucking noise!
Yeah, shut London down. Shut them down. Shut the police down.
That was awesome. Now I want to introduce you to one of our board members.
Shut the square mile down.
He's been here from the beginning. The hero that is Virgil.
Thank you, Sherry. Thanks all of you for coming here. I'm a bit nervous. I never spoke in front of such a big audience. Perhaps many people are asking themselves, what am I doing here today? I am so-called I live in a rented flat. I am a working class family. I have 2 jobs and other 2 side activities, but not illegal, as many of them would think. I'm a human rights activist and also a member of the Green Party.
Hi.
I'm here today
have
to
a good walk
with my brothers and sisters.
Get in the crop circle. Make a crop circle.
I consider this bill fascist because this is how the fascist regime done at their
take your rubbish home, guys.
People's civil and political rights and the rights of expression and assembly, and they abuse of the most vulnerable
friendly,
group. I'm here
I might have saw them yesterday.
To stand against the bill now until it's not too late. The bill is initiated by the country where the human rights were invented more than 800 years ago, when Magna Carta was adopted.
Magna Carta 2021 is coming!
For breaching it. So pretty, Boris, and
oath
company,
to yourself.
You can't play with human rights.
Swear your oath to yourself.
Instead of fulfilling their responsibility to ensure equal access to public services, what is the Conservative government doing?
Oh, I don't want everyone homeless that can't can't work full time, they want everybody to starve, food banks, get rid of all the support. They've cut the local authorities by half on the funding for young people to get housed. There's more of them on the street. It's disgusting. I know lots of them under the age of 35, struggling to find work, nowhere to live.
But don't worry,
because they haven't got anywhere to go for various reasons.
More private contacts with your friends, I mark myself.
Stirring it. Then.
You have lost the social justice balance, and anti-Gypsy remain the most accepted form of hate crime in today's society. You ignore us and deny us the right of representation. You don't involve us even in decision-making process.
That's a lot nicer. Wow.
We are tired of fake consultations.
Lovely. There's more gravy in there.
Thicken it up.
Is national strategy to tackle the Gypsy, Roma and traveler inequalities. Adopted in 2019.
No electric bill here.
The strategy has an allocated budget of £200,000. In the very same year, the very same government allocated £80 million for travellers' site eviction. The government rate of tax.
Well, this is better than free electric. You get warm with the firewood.
In other words,
and it's a cooker as well.
Having the bean.
Better than living in a house, especially in the summer.
Just imagine how
don't
much
live
money
at home
they
in the summer.
To implement the Bill fascist measures.
We live full time,
no representation
like
in
my friend
Equality
here.
And Human Rights Commission or Holocaust Commission. Our lack of representation and misrepresentation is caused also by our incapacity of solidarity. Let's accept the cultural and ethnic differences among us. The diversity is beautiful.
It is.
Always in their
it's
eyes,
now.
All of us are the same unaltered gypsies. Roma or Romani gypsies, Irish, Scottish, Welsh, new Woo. Travelers, showmen, or both bureaus. We are all in the same shit.
Yeah.
Sorry, this is the first English word I have learned.
Yeah.
Let's fight the anti-gypsies together. The word gypsy itself doesn't reflect you belonging to an ethnic group, but that you are a second-class citizen. Let's show them that we are many. In democratic society, the numbers count. We don't have to reinvent the wheel. We just have to learn from other human rights movements like Jewish community, Black Lives Matter, LGBTQ3, plus Free Palestine and other racist movements. The most degrading and dangerous anti-gypsies, the state institutional anti-gypsies. Through their attitudes and policies, they encourage the extremist group to act at their own accord. State people, be aware. We woke up. Opre Robalen, Namaiso.
Thank you very much. Virgil, Opre Ona. Just want to give a big shout out to a veteran of the new traveller scene. From the Battle of the Beanfield and the Fool, this man in the orange jacket is called Tish. Hello, his name is Alan Lesh. And he goes a red circle 1 hour on the road. When the Criminal Justice Act happened in 1994, this man personally predicted levels of police surveillance through Operation Snapshot that you wouldn't believe. PC Michael Keane at Advisors Police Station was given £1 million worth of funding to monitor the tattoos, number plates, helicopter movements and vehicles between traveller sites. And it was Tash who told all of you travellers across the country it's happening. And no one believed him. Years later, he was right. So, watch his website, one eye on the road, Tash.